Hello LEGO fans, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a LEGO City set from summer of 2014. This is the Arctic Icebreaker and it comes with 717 parts. Alright, Arctic Icebreaker set, and here is the Arctic Icebreaker itself. It's a ship based on one of the larger hulls that LEGO has made. It's the exact same size of hull used for the last Coast Guard set. You just got it molded in orange color here. This thing actually will float. Not a whole lot of features to it on the deck, but it does provide some interesting parts. Most notably, these parts here on the sides are new for 2014. I believe you'll see that here and also in the cargo train set in blue in that case. It's going to be a very useful part in the future. This is your whole kind of command deck, and we will be looking at that on the inside. We've got few little details up on top, including a little radar bar that can rotate around here. The easiest way to get in to the top is just to swing all this open. And down inside there you'll find one single captain's chair. He has a couple of consoles to look at and a steering wheel. Closing that up, looking down on the forward deck, you actually have a windlass that you can actually work to wind up the anchor. You see it just lets that go. This will fall down to what would be the water level, and you can easily just wind that back. And behind here we have what looks to be an engine room. It's an odd place to have an engine so far up front, but it's just a little thing to add a little more detail and take up some interior space. Speaking of interior space, you can get inside the entire main structure by taking all of this off as one big assembly. Inside of there you just have two beds and that's it. The smokestack assembly back here is nicely done, designed for a smokestack that I haven't seen before. Notice that the back of the superstructure is completely open though. That's a little bit awkward to me. It makes it easy to put more minifigs in there. You know, you have that extra space, but it's just weird to me to have it completely open without a door or anything. Up top here, we do have a couple of antennae, a little dish, and your standard marker lights. On either side, you've got ladders that can be dropped down, because remember, this thing is working in icy conditions, so frequently you will just stop and be able to drop a person down or load people up from the surface. On the intersection here, you've got a cargo deck and a helicopter landing pad, so the cargo deck can take these assemblies. You can hold on to some stuff. You can also pick up and place some of your ice chunks in there that you pick up from the surface. So just a couple different options there, and we'll look at those a little bit more closely. And then you've got also space to actually land your helicopter and get it on there and get it actually pretty secure so that's not going to fall off. As I mentioned, yes, the boat does float even fully loaded. There's a quick look at the helicopter now just by itself. Small, kind of awkward design to it. These are weird lines and you're seeing lots of different colors showing through on there. It's also got skids, and skids kind of turn into pontoons towards the back, and it's also very low to the ground. This one's just weird to me. It does have a bubble canopy which can be opened to place your pilot figure in there, and this one does have a winch on the back so you can use it to actually pick things up. It's just your standard crane hook there, so you can hook that up to anything that has a hoop on it. So here's one option, here's another option, and I don't think you're supposed to do this, but this kind of works too. That's a really small little snow machine, snowmobile thing. Very simple, small parts count, but it does the job, you know? It's obvious what it is, and it's a good thing to play with because, well, it just works. Set also includes this larger tracked vehicle, and I like this one a lot better. It's got a snow plow which can actually be retracted. You can pull that up, use it for moving a lot of material. It's also able to angle to the sides very realistically. I like that. And on the back, it's got a little tipper bed, so you can put stuff in there and dump it off. It also has a chain that you can optionally attach for picking things apart, opening things up and dragging things along. And there you can I just want to show you how the tipper bed is actually able to angle up like that to really dump stuff off. Also have a little walkie-talkie over on this side and part of a chainsaw on this side. And to get your guy in there, you're just going to take the whole roof off and probably want to take off the windscreen as well. This is good for the type of mining and exploration that they're doing for picking up materials, because you can put one big block of ice with the minerals inside on the bed, and you can drag another one along behind you. So you can kind of do double duty with this thing. You can also use that same hook to pull apart this ice wall by just dragging the thing along. Here's a better look at that ice wall, fully assembled. It's not too big, but it's nice to get something vertical, a little bit different from the norm, from the rest of the sets from this theme. Kind of an awkward gap back here. Would have been nice if that was closed up, but this thing does work well. Easy to pull off that front piece and get at the mineral inside. For more standard fare, they include three of these blocks of ice they're supposed to be, and these can be opened up to get at the mineral inside. Now here's your kind of Arctic base camp for this set. A few different assemblies go together with this one. Here you've got kind of a large area work light, and that's really all that is. This one's a little bit shaky. It's kind of on shaky ground. It won't fall apart, but just doesn't have the tightest connections in it. This over here is your main communication satellite transceiver dish, and that's able to rotate around. You can also change the angle of it to make sure you're tracking the satellite correctly. And you also have a little gas tank here, which can have any different kind of fuel that you want it to represent. Little container down at the base that you can put some tools in. And then there's the main structure, elevated off the ground, nice round top to it. Unfortunately, this shows up the differences in colors that LEGO often gives us for orange. You know, you can see that this is much lighter here than this. It's really a little bit unfortunate that they're not able to be a little more consistent than that. You expect better from LEGO, I think. And you got some tool racks on the sides, extra set of snowshoes there. This is an old train style door, actually looks pretty good in this application. That opens up, and that's big enough for minifigs to get in, but it's not big enough for us huge figs to get in with our huge fingers. So they made it so that you can open up the entire thing on both sides. Inside you can see a little bit of a lab. That's supposed to be a microscope there for looking at some samples that you pick up. You've got a little storage container here, another coffee mug. From the other side, you can see that you've got one of the mineral deposits in that container there. And you've also got a computer with some interesting stuff on the screen. Now, if you look carefully, you can see they've actually got some pretty wild stuff going on this screen. On the vertical axis, they've got cubic meters per second, so a measure of volumetric flow. And then down on the bottom, they've got one reference to deuterium helium 3, which is all about fusion, and then they've got temperature expressed in thousands of electron volts. That's just crazy. Set has two of these liftable cargo crates, which can be used for multiple purposes, and they've got right now some smaller crates inside with tools. You've got a pickaxe there, got a metal detector, and there's a circular saw inside. Those individual crates can also be taken out, and you can substitute in there one of these large big old pieces of ice if you want to carry them inside of there instead of carrying the ice bits by themselves. You've also got this dog sled, which can carry the crates like that. Same exact thing, so it's compatible. You can swap them back and forth. This is a pretty nicely done sled. You've got four of the new Huskies. These are a new mold for 2014, and they've got multiple colors molded into the main plastic, and they also painted the faces on fully, including the white on the front of the face and little whites in the ears to make sure that they always have the same expressions, even though the bodies will vary. You can see you've got more gray on the one towards the rear there, and all of those will change up a little bit, so you can see more white in the face or the head of this one. That's kind of nice that you get a little bit of uniqueness there. It makes them all look different rather than just being clones of each other. This is nicely hinged right here in the center. Works pretty nicely to lead the thing around. Got a set of binoculars there. Walkie-talkie over there. There's your spot for your driver to sit. And that's a printed piece with the Arctic logo on it. We also get one of the new polar bears with this set. It's the same mold as the brown bear we've gotten with recent city sets. Just recolored and painted a little bit differently here. This one is articulated, and he doesn't have to be carrying the fish around, of course. You can pull that out, but you can move the head up and down. You can also make him stand up. However, he's not really gonna stay standing up unless he's on a studded base, because there's just a little bit too much weight towards the front. 7 minifigs included with this set, so we'll look at them in two groups so you can see their accessories a little bit better. You see just a DSLR kind of still camera, a film camera supposedly on the next one over, somebody with nothing, and then somebody with an ice chainsaw. Notice 3 different torso prints here. This one is different, this one is different, these two here are the same. All 3 of these leg prints are the same, and this guy just has a dark blue set of legs. And turning those to the sides, you can start to see a little more of the shapes of those newer hoods if you haven't seen those before. Got the kind of comical old style tape printing on the side of the camera piece. And here's a look at all of these from behind. Now, none of these heads have secondary faces on them, but with the hoods removed, you can at least see the main faces better. And here are the other 3 minifigs. This one on the left is actually the captain of the Icebreaker ship. In the middle, you've got a lab scientist, and this guy is a pilot for the helicopter. All of those torsos are also new for 2014. So the set comes with a lot of minifigs and also comes with a lot of other components and provides a tremendous amount of play value. This is a full-on play set for sure. I have to admit, I'm a little bit disappointed by the ship, just the small number of parts contained in it. You know, it's not very intricate, not very interesting overall. It's basically just a big boat that you can put stuff on. I think if you're looking for a big boat set, the last Coast Guard set was a lot better, and there are some other options from the recent past that you can still pick up for decent prices. I feel like this set really shines for all of the little things included with it. None of them are really great on their own, but just the sheer number of them kind of makes up for it. To me, this is just more of a quantity over quality kind of set. So those are my thoughts about this one. I hope that you enjoyed this look at this set, and I hope that you will share your own thoughts about the set in a comment down below. Thank you very much for watching, and be sure to come back for more, because more videos are on the way.